Hello and welcome. Today I'd like to demonstrate a new low-cost highway interchange design that I've been looking into. Now on this channel I'd like to compare and investigate unusual interchange and intersection designs, but sometimes though I find a design that I think could and maybe should be used in the real world. Now you can see the interchange flowing freely here, but let's take a closer look to see how this is arranged. Now, if we look at the lane connector here, we can see that the rightmost lane is dedicated to traffic turning right. The next lane is for traffic turning left, goes under this bridge and branches off from the main highway. And the inner two lanes are for traffic going straight ahead. Now, we can also see this in the traffic route view. So we have lane for turning right, the next lane for turning left, and the other two lanes for going straight ahead. Now when I let the traffic run, we can see that nobody has to change lanes in the middle of the interchange, and traffic can flow very freely. So what type of interchange are we looking at here? Well, the best way I think I can explain it is that it's a modified divided volleyball intersection made in the style of the Pinavia intersection, hence the name. Now, the divided volleyball intersection looks something like this. Now, this is my first attempt at one. It's got a nice square section in the middle, a bunch of tight turns, but its best characteristic is that it only uses four bridges. Now, my next attempt looked like this. Change where the bridges were to have them on the exits, not the entrances. And after that, you have to configure where the link roads leave and join the highways. Next, I applied the general ideas of the Pinavia intersection like this one. So the main highways curve to the right, and then left and right again. And that gives us this. Now, this is just one version, and using this general layout, we have a lot of flexibility with what we can do with the roads. So this next version uses a standard three-lane highway with different link roads. I also have a bigger, more realistic version, again with kind of a different configuration of the roads that link between the highways. So what are the main pros and cons of this design? Well, to start with, it's big. With realistic curves and gradients, it's going to take up more space than a stack interchange, so it's not going to be suitable for every location. But on the upside, the unused area in the center of the interchange is mostly in one big block, so it could be reused for other purposes. Next, there's no straight-through route, so drivers not leaving the highway will have to curve right and left to get through the interchange. Finally, unlike a stack interchange where traffic always leaves and joins the main highway from the rightmost lanes, this interchange has one case where traffic must join the highway in the leftmost lane. Next, on the positive side, we have low cost. With this design, we have just four short single-span bridges. Now, because overpasses are the most expensive parts of an interchange to build, having just four should save us a lot of money. Not just in construction, but also in the maintenance and repair of that bridge over its lifespan. Finally, on the positive side, we have adaptability. Because the interchange is mostly at ground level, it becomes very easy to expand or reconfigure. Something like adding a lane to improve traffic flow in one direction becomes much easier. This design also adapts well to different terrain. We can swap the highways to go over or under bridges, and we can also change the tunnels if we need to. So I'll wrap things up here, but I'd be interested to know what people think. I know this interchange is only going to work in certain conditions, but I think it might have some potential for use in the real world. Anyway, I'll put links to the Steam workshop versions in the video description below, and I'll leave you with just a few more reviews of the interchange.